It's hanging off that tree right there.
Yeah, metal hickory tree. Hey, goat. Come on, let's go. I'm gonna wander down here with the goat to the creek. Check this out. Deer. Come on, goat. Let's go.
Is that in the way? Is that gonna affect your jumping skills? Come on.
Good jump. Come on. More deer. And
deer doing that too.
They're everywhere.
See where my goat's at.
She's coming. She's coming. Come on, goat. You have to talk to goats like babies, or they don't listen. That's what I'm going to say anyway. Come on, goat. You coming? Lots of burl out here. Mainly cherry burl. And fat wood. Look at that. Guarantee you that's fat wood. All right there. Probably 100 pounds of it under the ground. I could be totally wrong. Come on, goat. Let's go. I'll say, go ahead and say this while they got me wandering around with this camera. I am no shape, form, or fashion a professional at this. I just get out here and have a good time. I know what works for me. And I just try to share some of the knowledge that I do have with you guys, and maybe y'all can use it, or just watch my goat, or whatever y'all want to do. We got 6 miles of horse trails out here that we can walk on our property, so, or property that I have access to. It borders our property. We can walk for days. After all the bush we want to. Come on, goat. Come on. What do you hear? That's running water. Come on, let's go down the hill. Check this out. Pretty cool. This rock right over here always. I'm not so wet. Check it out. That's, you can drink that. That's fresh water. It's always like that. Hey, goat. Hey, everybody. Very own tough possum survival scarf miniature. Yeah, a lot of people ask, what does your goat do? Pretty much whatever she wants to do. But 90% of the time, she does whatever I'm doing. So that's a huge plus. If you, I don't know if it's zoomed in, how you can see that hill people gear chest rig. Awesome. go over this. No. Carries way more than you actually want to carry in it. But I
put some shot cord on the bottom, and I have a tough possum survival scarf that lives on the bottom. Awesome piece of kit. I'll go over this another day. But in the front pocket of this thing, I keep some cordage. Matter of fact, I'm gonna do this. Wazoo survival gear. Slap bracelet. That is actually a scale on the back ruler. But I'll take it. Let me see a little bit better. Cordage, Sassy's SD card, the flashlight, compass with pace counter beads, duct tape, a lighter with a Ranger band, some micro cord, a Victorinox Swiss Army Farmer. Got knife, I don't have any fingernails. Knife, wicked nasty awl, that thing is nasty. Saw, good knife to have. Multi-tool. Ferro rod in the front pocket. These things, that wood that I collected a while ago. Let's move on. These things are designed so you can carry a firearm in the back pocket. I normally don't carry a gun out here unless I'm going to kill something. And then I'm going to eat it. So I'm not doing that today. In the first zippered compartment, a wax canvas duty by PNW Bushcraft. Awesome piece of kit. It's a fire kit. Like I said, there's so much stuff in this kit. It's ridiculous, but it's handy to have. This is an entire fire kit in Altoids 10. It's got a grater with a Wazoo survival gear burnable business card on there. Some wet fire, some live fire, some fat wood with jute. And a lighter. This also is full of fire making stuff. Just to have it. Now I've got to pack everything back in here. Nice little Tandy closure. Good stuff. Another flint and steel kit. Tough possum pouch. This is the one that I use the most. This guy is Self-Reliance Outfitters. I got it at Pathfinder Gathering last year. The best striker that I have. Works really well. When it comes, I think it's got like a clear coat on it that you got to take off, but then it starts blowing flames, or sparks, I should say. Piece of flint, char tin. Some jute twine, normal flint and steel kit. String light, well used pocket bellows, batteries, another lighter, red hot hog beef fat, a small roll of bank line, or bug spray, a small diamond sharpener, an SE Azula, well used. I don't believe in having a knife and not using it. Awesome, awesome blade. Got my little fancy bead on there. It likes to whack you right on the knuckles when you're using it. And a string light headlamp. That's it for the center pocket. This is just a bigger possible pouch, really. And the last compartment, I have orange cotton material, 100% cotton, signal mirror, a Mylar emergency blanket, poncho. I got a Write and Rain notebook just in case. 55-gallon drum liner. This is actually two tourniquets, but I also use them to, if I got a jacket or something, I'll take and push them through and wrap around my jacket and hang my jacket off the top or the bottom of this. And like I said earlier, if you cut yourself out here, you're probably not going to want to try wasting time with a Band-Aid. I got a buff, a pencil, a folder cup, because I can drink out of this creek, a Fox Light Gear ground claw. I use it for a kneeling pad because, again, my knees are in the dirt. A piece of Titan cord. And it's pretty cool stuff. But that's it for this center compartment. That's basically it for my chest bag. I'm going to put this inside too.
It's probably what everybody knows me best for. I am the faithful sidekick to Bushcraft Sassy. She's not my sidekick. I am that to her. We started the whole Bushcraft. I've always done stuff outside, you know, been kind of outdoorsy, camping. But when Sassy was born, we bottle fed her, and she become kind of a pet or member of the family, really, and I became, for all intents and purposes, her mother. So she just stuck with me everywhere I went. And most of the time it was out here doing stuff or somewhere in the woods. And one day I had the bright idea of buying this tactical canine rig and putting it on her and seeing if she would wear it. And she would. So I started giving her, putting pouches and stuff on her and different pieces of equipment, going and doing outside stuff just as much as I do. And that's kind of where Sassy came from, or how it all started. We did a thread on the Bushcraft USA forum called Gearing the Goat. You can do a Google search, that'll pop up. It shows the whole how it started from her having nothing to where she is right now. And I update that pretty often, as well as on Instagram. You can follow us on Instagram. It's at Bushcraft Kelso, or hashtag Bushcraft Sassy will find us. And we're always doing something. She's normally up to no good. She's as active in her everyday shenanigans as she is out here. You never know what you're going to get with her, but well worth the watch. I mean, it's entertaining. It's like having TV in the woods, you know, Comedy Central on four legs. But it's enjoyable. I enjoy doing it. She enjoys it, or I wouldn't make her do it. If she ever gets to the point where she doesn't want to do it anymore, you guys are going to have to do it out Bushcraft Sassy and just hang out with me.